Hello, I'm Mr. Harmandir, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, and I render exposition of the parables. And here I'm doing today, which is Matthew 22, verse 1 to 14. Holy Gospel of our Supernatural Father Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, same thing in different languages, delivered by the First Anointed Christ, which in Punjabi, my native language, we call Satguru Jesus, of the highest living God, Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, that dwells within his temple of God, created by the demiurge Porter, the Lord of the Nature, Yahweh, Brahma, Khudah, the greatest artist, you know. He left no stone unturned. Everything is perfect. And it is called Harmandir. Har mean God, Mandir mean temple. Our Emmanuel, God is with us. If you are not greedy person, if you are greedy, then Satan is in, blood-sucking Satan is in, and God is out. So you need to be honest. What is inside should be outside, not dishonest. Christianity is not for the crook, it's for the simple-minded, honest people. According to Saint Matthew 22, verse 1 to 14. And, oh dear. There is the ideal rabbi, and this is the tree of life scripture. And the root of the tree of life is, the top root is oral Torah, which is here. If this oral Torah is missing, then this tree is dead. Among the Jewish people, this tree was dead. They had no common sense, and they hated light. So that was the darkness. Among the Samaritans, this tree was, they had the knowledge of the oral Torah, and this tree was green. That's why the Samaritan picked up the wounded person and looked after him. Whereas the Pharisee passed by, the Sadducee passed by, because they were Mammon related, no mercy in their heart. So Jesus again, in reply, spoke to the chief priests and the elders of the people in parables, saying, the royal kingdom of Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm. Now, in the Bible, they have put this kingdom of heaven and not the royal kingdom of God. So these people are messianic Jews who wrote the Bible and other things. And they don't know the difference between the kingdom of heaven and of God. So this is the kingdom of heaven and hell of the rabbis. And this is the royal kingdom of God, which is in our heart, not outside. This is outside, this is inside, inside your heart. This is what Jesus has brought in. And here is the relationship between between our supernatural father, which is Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, this middle candle. And these are the pots created by the potter Yahweh. Yahweh Brahma Khudah. So the soul in it that makes these pots living come from this one. This is the knowledge of the oral Torah. So without this, without the knowledge of the oral Torah, these parts are dead. Let the dead bury their dead. They only read the dead Bible, like this book, you know, like this book I have written. And the dead will read this book. And they argue over this one. This is written here and there. Whereas the men of the Holy Spirit, they don't need a book. They go by their heart. and they can explain everything what they do. But the men of letters can't, they, unless they have the oral Torah knowledge. As Jesus, when he was in the synagogue, he was explaining the scripture to the very root, because he had the knowledge of the oral Torah. Much more in my other videos. So the Royal Kingdom of Elohim, Allah Parbrahm, which is inside here, and this is the temple of God. God lives in his temple, not outside. So we don't say prayer and fasting. No, that was to Elohim, alienated. And he is in heaven. Our Father is here. He is not in heaven. And not the kingdom of heaven, of Yahweh, Brahma, Khudah, etc. in law and order. Luke 16, verse 16, law and prophets were till John the Baptist. And after that one, this royal kingdom of God, which has a narrow gate, was opened by Christ Jesus. So this is the royal kingdom, this is the kingdom of Yahweh, prophet Elijah, my God is Yahweh. Law and prophets were here. Here our covenant is of letters. Transgression against the letter is sin. So the baptism of John the Baptist is of repentance, because they had become Jew outwardly. In the temple priest was making them Jew outwardly, while the Jew is one who is inwardly of the heart, spiritual, not physical. So not a single Jew died during the Holocaust, because it is spiritual self, not the physical self. So here John the Baptist baptized Jewish men in water in the name of Abraham, and Jesus in the name of his heavenly Father Yahweh. And these sons of man, now the chosen people, they have a strong ego of their being the son of Abraham, who was Adam, Sarah was Eve, and Promised Land Garden of Eden. They are the demonstration nation of the world, and that's why they are called nation of priests. So they are very egoistic. So Jesus was curing the leper. Leprosy is a very bad disease. And they were being cured by Jesus. Out of 10, 9 were Jewish one. All of them went to their rabbi to show them that, hey, now we are clean. And they were sitting in the synagogue. Let the dead bury their dead. They were burying the dead there. And they did not bother about Christ Jesus. They did not come back to thank him even. A Samaritan man of salt, when he found that he is cured, he returned back to Jesus to thank him. And wanted to join Jesus. But Jesus said, no, you don't need me. Because your rabbis are very efficient. They possessed 5 talents. They were nation of prophets. And the other one, the people of the chosen people, they needed the doctor, Christ Jesus, not the Samaritans or the Gentiles. But the Gentile Samaritans, they appreciated his word much more than the Jewish people. Jewish people appreciated the least. As in India, people of the Khatri tribe, they were the least people who appreciate the message of second coming of Jesus in the name of Christ Nanak. We call it Satguru Nanak. And most of the people, Khatris, they just carry on with their own things. They did not turn their face to, but they became even the enemy of Satguru Nanak and his house. We people, Gentile, we appreciated the most. I come from the Jat tribe. My people were the greatest number who turned to Christ Nanak. And we gave the, upheld the name of religion as the Samaritans did. So this is the kingdom of heaven and hell of the rabbis. And here you must bury the seed, ego of your tribal ego, and turn it into plant, which is twice more, and then craft it to the true vine, Christ Jesus. Here your soul is concerned. Here we have one Father, we are all His children. That's why Jesus said, don't call anyone Father. We have one Father, God. And we are all sons of God. No daughter here. Son represents Father, not daughter. So here we are the fishers of men, not of no woman here. So here is flesh, man and a woman here, secular life. Here spiritual of sadhus. Sadhus don't have tribal identity. So that's what it is, you know, here. Purely spiritual. And here purely secular. Flesh, here your deeds. Your deeds count, your works count. Deeds. And here your works count. Works for living. Your birth count here. Your birth count here and your deeds count here. So, there are many things I have told in my other videos. I don't want to repeat them again and again. So, Jesus again in reply spoke to the chief priests and the elders of the people in parables, saying, the royal kingdom of Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, etc., and not the kingdom of heaven of the Yahweh, Brahma, Khudah, etc., the demiurge, may be likened to a royal king. Royal king is our supernatural father, God, and not the secular king. Secular king will take taxes. Our royal father gave you free 3 years, which is the gospel 3 years, and not money 3 years. So secular kings who give a wedding feast for his son. Son is Christ Jesus. He gave a wedding feast. He dispatched his servants. Servants are angels. Angels are the messengers of our supernatural father, so they are visible. So the angels to summon the invited guests, the sons of man, faithful to Abraham and to Yahweh, as Lazarus was, to the feast, but they refused to come. The temple priest. Temple priests did not want to leave their position as these so-called priests. If you tell them that in Jesus we are royal priests and we don't take money, oh, they won't like it. They are already in a comfortable position in societies. And with the dog collar, everybody call him Father, 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 whereas we have one Father God and they are fake fathers, hypocrites. The temple priests, hypocrites, as Pope is, Pope and his stooges are, you know. A second time, so first was a message to the temple priests, come and have the feast. And the second time was to the twice born people. A second time he sent other servants, saying, servants are apostles, are angels. Tell those invited, the chosen people, the twice born people, you know, especially the chosen one, behold, I have prepared my banquet. My calves and fattened cattle are killed. That will be a very tasty meal, as he gave to the 5,000 people when Yahweh provided that meal. That meal was very tasty against manna they were eating in the wilderness of repentance. And everything is ready. Come to the feast. Some ignore the invitation. That means it went to the twice born people. And among the twice born people, they understood the message. And they understood the gospel. But they put it under bushel. because they are frightened of people getting annoyed or upset. As this Britain is a nation of shopkeepers, they can't preach gospel. Gospel is bitter. So they want to deliver sugar-coated sermon as the shopkeeper will deliver. So that is the people they went. Behold, I prepared my banquet, my calves and fattened cattle are killed, and everything is ready. Come to the feast. Some ignore the invitation. They put the light under bushel. As a retired major, general, you know, Roddy Porter, who runs a military ministry, and here is his card. And he went to Iraq, and he found that there were no weapons of mass destruction that Saddam Hussain had it. So he came to Reading to deliver us a sermon, and people asked him, you know, he told them definitely there were no weapons of mass destruction. So Tony Blair and Bush, they were blasphemers. They told lies from the core of their heart. And that blasphemy then started killing people one after the other. They destroyed Iraq, they destroyed Libya and other countries. And these rebels, Americans support the rebels against Syria. And Russia supports Syria, the rightful government. So this is the character of these sons of Satan. So the Jewish people in America, they are the one who are creating havoc all over the world. And a Green Party MP made this poster cartoon. Jewish man in an American flag holding the sickle, which is David's cross, and they are the one who are bringing all this bloodshed. The Jews in America are doing this one. If you want peace, you make a banners and posters of this one, distribute among the people to alert them that all these troubles in the country, one after the other, is caused by the American Jews. They are the saltless people. They invaded, they destroyed the country of their forefather Abraham, who was taken from Iraq area. If they can do that to their forefather Abraham, who was Abraham, then they can't spare anyone else. So that is what, if they killed Jesus, and they were saltless people, and so are these tares getting bundled up in Israel for final burning. Matthew 13, verse 24 to 30 is getting fulfilled. So he's running a military ministry. He was in Iraq and confirms that Saddam Hussein had no weapon of mass destruction. And Tony Blair and Bush were blasphemers, but he won't open his mouth. He won't open his mouth. You know that centurion, he was under Roman rule. So he was rightful, you know, that I can't invite you to my house because I'm not a free man bound by the Roman. And so this man, Major General, which is retired, he's a free man. He should open his mouth. He's not. Keeping the putting light under bushel. And went away. One to his farm. So the twice born people, and the other one, twice born people, they went to the farm. Farm is a business. And another to his business. The twice born people, only they can do business. Once born people, they can't. They work as laborers, serving others. The rest laid hold of his servants. Rest means the stooges of the temple, once born. Once born people, they don't know what religion is a god is. So whatever the temple priest tell them, they do it. So this is the Satan. It will become clear here. So this is the Satan, you know, this Al-Jamar Al-Aqsa, the temple high priest. Temple high priest. This is religious fanatics here. And he's controlling them, leaning against this hillock. And this one is in the Hajarite. And so these people who are the stooges of the temple high priest, they beat the apostles, they beat the prophets and everything. So that's the other one, you know. So, and went away, one to the farm and the other to the business. The rest mean the fanatic devils. John 8 verse 44, he said, your forefathers are liars, and that is his native language. And he was super bastard fanatic devils. And those super bastard fanatic devils, they laid their hand hold on his servants, the apostles, as the temple priest did to Jesus. And these hireling dog collar priests do mistreated them. These dog collar hot priesting, they are Judas Iscariot in sheep clothing. They are of the temple priest. Temple priest, they are filled Matthew 12, verse 43 to 45, making the situation worse than before the arrival of Jesus. So they mistreated them and killed them as heretic. You know that in Gennesaret, there were two people who were saint and they were preaching gospel. The local rabbi said, oh no, no, don't listen to them. Put them in the silence of the graveyard. And so they did. I got it here. The royal king, our supernatural father, Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, etc., were enraged as Jesus was at Gennesaret for maltreating two saints who were locked in the silence of the graveyard with heavy chains. So they took them and put them in the silence of the graveyard with heavy chains. But what Jesus has set free, nobody can bind it. So it is a real freedom. So the chains were getting broken by the angel. Chains that the angels of God used to break them and sent his troop. So then again, remember that Jesus drowned 2,000 swine as a punishment to them. And so this sent his troops, that means God sent the troops, these Roman ones. The Roman destroyed those murderers in the temple in 70 AD. So all those murderers were bundled up in Jerusalem, and they were destroyed by the fire and other things, and burned their city, Jerusalem. Then he said to his servants, the angels, like prophet Stephen. Now you remember the Stephen was baptizing Jewish men in water in the name of Abraham, which the temple priests did not like. They wanted to make them Jew outwardly, not of heart. So they called him to the temple, and he gave a long speech that our forefather Abraham was a noble man. Don't make fake sons of Abraham by circumcising the Gentile and the slaves. Circumcision is the tribal mark of Abraham to Isaac. Nobody else can have it. So these Mohammedan, by having the circumcision, which is they are not of Samaritan race, but Aryan and white and all that, you know, they are super bastards, because they are change their tribal identity by become through circumcision. So that is what they are, you know, these mullahs are making. They tried to introduce circumcision in the church, but they were not successful. These messianic Jews, they are crook, you know. Then he said to his servants, the angel, like Prophet Stephen, in the name of, who was working in the name of John the Baptist, baptizing Jewish men in water, the feast is ready. Those people who are clean-hearted, you know, to them the message went, but those who were invited, the chosen people, remember, 10 lepers were cured, 9 were Jewish, and after being cured, they were saltless. They did not come even to thank Jesus. So Samaritan man came to thank Jesus. He was a man of salt, and they were prophet, nation of prophets. People were not worthy to come. So light came among his own, but they loved darkness to carry on with their malpractices, cheating people. Go out, therefore, into the main roads, the world at large, and invite to the feast whoever, whomever you find worthy. Find worthy mean a person of salt, people of conscience. They could only be people of God. So that's why St. Thomas went to South India, where people were people of salt, because they had this name of the boy, name of his father, name of his village, and his surname. By this one he was recognized that he is son and so. If he does anything wrong, then the people who is victim of his wrongdoing, he will go to his father and tell him the story that your father, your son has done wrong to me. So the father would be put to shame. So they are not shameful people. Sorry, they are people of shame, not shameful. Shameful people are in the North India, where I come from. And so no saint was born there. Only Saint Thomas went there, because what applied to flesh, the opposite applied to spirit. The local rabbis, a local priest said, oh, we are not inefficient yet. You are coming to confuse our people. So they killed St. Thomas over there. But there were people who were twice born. And they listened to them and they carry on his work. But those priests, they were jealous, as the temple priests in Jerusalem were. And they killed St. Thomas. Much more I can tell in detail if somebody is interested. So the servant went out into the streets and gathered all they found, bad and good alike. And the hall was filled with guests, free of Mammon. Remember that Jesus said, when you go on a preaching tour, don't take money in your pocket, no two shoes, no two tunic. So people entering the church, the hall, they sold their possessions and they entered it. Anais and Sapphira, they sold their possessions, they kept back money. So Peter killed them, for they were blasphemers. They told lies to Peter from the core of their heart. So that's what Mammon does, you know. If you are no Mammon, like sadhus, maltreated, then you speak what is inside is outside. No hypocrisy. But when the royal king, our supernatural father, Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, etc., came in to meet the guests, he saw a man there, Judas Iscariot, the thief stealing money from the church purse, as the hireling dog-collar priests do as their salaries, as if they are working for Mammon and not for God. not dressed in a wedding garment. So wedding garment is one that does not carry money. No money in your pocket. That is why Peter killed two blasphemers, Anais and Sapphira, for telling blasphemy. Tony Blair and Bush are the greatest blasphemer that deserve the crown of Satan. He said to him, crown of Satan is given by Church of England. Church of England is a church of Satan. They worship Mammon. And those people who bring in Mammon, they say they glorify God. So crown of Satan, he said to him, my friend, how is it that you came in here without a wedding garment, free of Mammon? Take no money in your pocket, no two shoes or no scrip, the Bible, the Jewish 11 Bible, as our covenant with God is of the Holy Spirit and not of the dead letters, which is common sense. That is why the good news of the birth of Jesus was broken by the angels to the shepherds tending their sheep faithfully. They were new skin, not drunk with the old wine of the dead letters. In the field and not into the temple priest who wanted to kill him. You remember Maggi went to tell the temple priest that where is your king? And they were so much upset, you know, the temple priests, hypocritically, they behaved to them. And they were not stupid. So after, they were also this to tell us, you know, that these temple priests, doctoral priests in churches, they are anti-Christ. So they are not, they work for money. And they don't like people who are free or who are honest. They themselves are thieves of the order of Judas Iscariot. So they will support thieves. I have found these ombudsmen and other people, organization, they are running government-approved mafias. They are cheat. And if anybody wants to know more, he can tell, ask me, and I will supply all the my cases. How they, these thieves, you know, they did no justice. They are mafia. The temple priest, but he was reduced to silence. So he was reduced to silence, Judas Iscariot. Then the royal king. Then the royal king that do not charge taxes. Royal king don't charge taxes, but the secular king do charge taxes. But rather give free his treasures, the gospel truth, in our hearts. With this gospel truth, it rests where your heart is. By his grace, it is by his grace he gives you, not that you can earn it or you can beg him. No, by his pleasure, said to his attendants, the angels, bind his hands and feet and cast him into, into the darkness outside, where there will be wailing and grinding of teeth. That is where Judas Iscariot was thrown out, separated from the light of the word Christ Jesus. So he was not worthy to have the light, so he was thrown into darkness. Many twice born, sensible people are invited, but few are chosen, are devoted to our supernatural Father, Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm. Most people, you know, when they work in the churches, they ask for money. There are monks who don't take money, who don't touch money. They are the one who will appreciate gospel. Anyone who take money and put on this robe, you know, hypocrisy, because you don't need hope. This dress provided by our supernatural father, by Yahweh, Brahma Khudah, is most beautiful. Lily of the field is better dressed than King Solomon in his best attire. That's why sadhus in India, they don't put any dress, they are naked. And they don't like clothes or anything, artificial beauty, no, natural beauty. So much more you can learn if you are interested and if you have common sense. Common sense is Holy Spirit, which you can misuse it to cheat people and become rich. And you can use the same common sense to earn the treasures of our supernatural father and be poor like Lazarus and be end up in the lap of Abraham or in the lap of our supernatural father, whereas the rich who cheated the other, they go to the hell where they are burning and cheating and everything. So this coronavirus is taking most of the cheating people, the rich people. And it's the end of the age approaching. Atomic war is expected on 14 May 2023, when Israel is 75 years old. Much more in my other videos. So our Father God blesses everyone in Agape. Agape is the unconditional divine love of our supernatural Father. So here it is. It is arrows. Agape. Arrows is the tribal love that Moses created in the wilderness. And there were no fighting among the brethren. That snake was lifted up. Agape is unconditional divine love, because in each one, whether you are good or bad, the soul of our supernatural Father is there. Here we have one Father. If we have one Father, whether you are good or bad, you are also the son of the same Father. So we don't fight with each other. Here we call it bhakti mari. If somebody hit your one cheek, you present the other cheek. Here, your body is concerned, Yahweh is concerned, to which belongs this earth and whatever you see with two naked eyes. Jesus made a whip to turn out the traitors from the court of his heavenly Father Yahweh. Jesus' father was Yahweh, that's why his name was Yeshua. Yeah, from Yahweh, Shua or Shiva means the primal Adam, firstborn of Yahweh, the second Adam. So here you have, the love, Agape, and then you have filial love here, and this is storge love here, storge. Storge love is one sitting at the table of our supernatural father. The seventh husband, when you marry, there is neither giving nor taking. So the all knowledge is there, no customers, and hope you enjoy it. Our Father God blesses everyone in Agape.